quantum mechanics is really about explaining the properties of the microscopic world, the materials our bodies are made up, our brains are made up at the very microscopic level. General relativity, or relativity theory in general, is about explaining the largest cosmic dimensions, space-time, gravity, the whole macroscopic order of the cosmos. And so you can imagine that they're at this macroscopic cosmic level needs to be connected to this super subatomic quantum level. How can this be done? And the two theories describing these two realms really can't do that. And they have not been compatible with each other since their inception. And since quantum mechanics was developed, there was a tension between the two. And I think this is the reason why David Bohm's theory is coming up again, because it's the only, was the first theory to have an underlying ontology, making a claim about a sub-quantum reality. And I think this is why people are drawn increasingly to this. But at the specific level, the Bohmian theory made a clear prediction about the non-locality of the world. What is non-locality? Non-locality is really, to put it in simple words, the profound discovery of the interconnectedness of the universe. What is the ability for human beings to act in the world? And observation is one aspect of it, but it sounds very passive, right? We are just observing what's already going on. But science is doing more, and human beings are doing way more than that. We are actually interacting with the world. We are changing the world to our needs. Then you end up with the biggest picture of a completely unified, universal perspective that also integrates the observer with the observed, and it overcomes the illusion of separation between observer and observed. And you are recognizing that it's all one act of observing.